Hello, and welcome to dbForge Studio for MySQL tutorial. In this video, we will learn how to use MySQL's slow query log to troubleshoot performance bottlenecks. The concepts we will cover here also apply to other variants of MySQL like MariaDB, Amazon Aurora, or Parcona. Depending on how it's configured, MySQL creates a number of log files when it's running. Some of these log files are created by default, others have to be enabled. Here is a list of these log files. The error log records any system errors found during the start, stop, and normal operation of the MySQL instance. The general query log records all client connections and commands run on the database instance. The binary log records all data modification commands run on the databases. The binary log is also used for replication. The relay log captures all the changes received from a replication source server. The DDL log or metadata log records the DDL changes made to any database. And lastly, we have the slow query log. The slow query log captures any SQL query running for more than a configured number of seconds. This value is dictated by the long query time variable. When troubleshooting a slow-running MySQL instance, we can look for a few different root causes such as high CPU, low available memory, excessive I/O, excessive locking, or poor and non-existing indexes. One of the ways to troubleshoot a slow MySQL server is to capture any slow-running queries in a log file and analyzing them later. By default, the slow query log isn't enabled, and it's not recommended to enable it in a production system unless there is a very good reason. That's because when the slow query log is enabled, MySQL must analyze every query and write any long-running query into the log file. This contributes to I/O overload. Also, depending on how busy the system is, the slow query log can get very large and quickly fill up the disk space. That's why the slow query log should be enabled only during performance troubleshooting and disabled immediately after the issue has been resolved. There are a few system variables that control how the slow query log behaves. The first one is, slow query log. If we set this variable to 1, the slow query log will be enabled. The second one is long query time. This variable's value is expressed in number of seconds. Any query running for more than the long query time will be logged in the slow query log. Now, if you set the long query time to a small value, you may end up with a large number of slow queries in the log. That's because the application could be running the same query thousands of times with different parameters. On the other hand, if you set this parameter to a high value, you may miss the actual slow queries causing the bottleneck. The ideal value should be the time it takes for the longest running query to finish during normal operations. So, if you expect your longest running MySQL query to take no more than 3 seconds, set this variable to 3. Then we have the parameter log queries not using indexes. If we set this parameter value to 1, MySQL will log every query that's not using any index, even if the query is taking less than the long query time value. Now, it may sound like a good idea to set this value to 1 so we can find which tables need indexes. But bear in mind, sometimes the query optimizer may not decide to use an index even if one exists. Therefore, setting this parameter to 1 doesn't necessarily mean finding tables that need indexing. Lastly, we have log output. This variable dictates the output location of the slow query log and the general log. This variable can have 3 values. When this is set to file, the slow query log and the general log are saved in the server's file system. When this is set to table, the slow query log is saved in the MySQL database's slow_log table, and the general log is saved in the MySQL database's general_log table. If this variable is set to none, it will turn off logging. In our example, we are running an Amazon RDS MySQL instance. We are logged into the database instance as the user administrator. This is the master user for this RDS instance. We want to see the values of the variables we just talked about, so we run the show variables command. As we can see, the slow query log is disabled. In dbForge Studio for MySQL, we can also select database from the main menu and then select server variables. Let's enable the slow query log and set the other variables. In Amazon RDS, the MySQL parameters are specified in a parameter group. The parameter group we are using here is the default one where slow query log is disabled. Instead of changing the default parameter group, we have created a new parameter group with the slow query log enabled. In this parameter group, we have specified the long query time as 3 seconds. By default, this value is 10 seconds. We are using a small value for demonstration purpose only. We have now changed the RDS instances property by removing the default parameter group and added the new one. Now we have to reboot the instance. The RDS instance is now back online. If we check the logging parameters again, we can see the slow query log is enabled and the logs are going into a table. If we look into the MySQL database, we can see a table called slow underscore log. This is the slow query log. We have a few fields in this table. Let's talk about the important ones. The user host field contains the combination of the MySQL username and the host running the query. Then we have query time. This is the total time in seconds the query took to run. The log time field shows the time the query was logged when running. The DB field shows the name of the database the query was running on. The SQL text field contains the actual query. Let's simulate some long-running queries now. Here, we are connected to a database and running a simple select query with a sleep function. This query will run but do nothing for 5 seconds. The query is now finished. Let's run another query. Here, we are using the MySQL benchmark function. It also runs longer than the slow query threshold. Both the queries were simulating slow operation, so let's check the slow underscore log table. As you can see, we have two records here. Each of our slow running queries have been logged because they have run over 3 seconds. We can also see the user we logged in as and the database the queries were running against. Sometimes you need to clear the slow query log. When slow queries are being logged into a table, you can't simply just truncate it. In RDS MySQL, you can run a command called RDS rotate slow log from the MySQL database. Once we run this command, the main slow query log table will be cleared, but the contents will be saved in another table called slow log backup. We can truncate this table to recover the disk space. So this is how we can use MySQL slow query log for troubleshooting long-running statements. In this video, we also saw how to check the slow query log related parameters and how to enable it. We also learned how to remove the slow query log entries. To know more, just download a 30-day free trial of dbForge Studio for MySQL and find out how effortless database management and administration could be.